judgment is the one related to Kanu, the appeal was dismissed, which is different from that of Imo, because the facts are not the same, and the Supreme Court gave the reason why that appeal was dismissed. We were responding there. But we lost in Sokoto on the ground that the document tender, the date that is born on the receipt, does not tally on the date the copies were given to the appellant. And that since the witnesses said there were outside versions, without corresponding English version, there was a problem. So well, that's the Supreme Court, and we are bound by the judgment.
The Supreme Court affirmed the concurrent findings and judgment of the Election Tribunal and the Court of Appeal. Wherefore, they found no merit in the appeal, and they affirmed the decision of the Court of Appeal. Wherefore, the appeal of the APC and its candidate was dismissed. And with this, this has finally brought to an end, a final end, the contest as to who is the rightful, who is the governor, the elected governor of Sokoto State, which now unequivocally and without any reservation has been laid in the hands of Right Honorable Aminu Waziri Tambuwa as the duly elected governor of Sokoto State.
The implication of the judgment is that it has brought to a final conclusion the contest over the governorship of Sokoto State, which the Supreme Court today have declared that the election was won by the party, by the PDP, as represented by Right Honorable Aminu Tambuwa, who has been returned today. The court has found no merit in the case at the appeal as brought by the appellants, and have so dismissed same graciously without cost. That's the implication as a party, as a candidate to the party. I think the party, this is one of the judgments that you can see that the Supreme Court went in depth into all the facts and the issues and did a thorough analysis in resolution of the case. So as the candidate to the party, we are very grateful and we are happy with the decision.
Justice has not only been done, but has been seen to have been done by all the observers. The court has done a thorough analysis of the entire petition and evidence, and has found that, one, in respect of the document tendered, all of them being public documents were not certified. And in respect of the witnesses that were called, all of them gave their evidence in Hausa, and the Hausa version of their evidence was not brought before the court. It was the translated version, and the translator was not called. So that made their testimonies as hearsay and unreliable. On the whole, the court found no merit in the appeal and affirmed the decisions of the two lower courts and the election of His Excellency Right Honorable Aminu Waziri Tambuwa, CFR Mutawalla Sokoto, as the duly elected governor of Sokoto State. We thank God the Almighty for this victory. It is a sweet victory. It is a hard fought battle from the lower court, from the first election, the run election, the first tribunal, the Court of Appeal, up to Supreme Court.
Because it is final. So that means that the Supreme Court itself accepts that it can make mistakes because they are human beings. To that extent, we cannot quarrel with the Supreme Court working so much under pressure with all these high-flight election petition cases. Today, for example, we had about 16 issues distilled for determination. About 18 issues, but only one issue was actually gone into. For example, we had won an interlocutory appeal on this matter before the same Supreme Court on the 23rd of September last year, which the tribunal ignored, which the Court of Appeal ignored, and which we brought before the Supreme Court. That issue was not pronounced upon at all. For example, today we cited the case which was decided in last week, Tuesday, on the 14th, Hope Uzodinma against INEC, where a PW54, a DCP Hussein, brought some electoral materials to the court, dumped them, and said he did not even know anything about them. The Supreme Court accepted the evidence bordering on 388 polling units. I gave the votes to Opposite Uzodinma. We used that case today, we cited that case to say the evidence of PW1 that was discarded, that PW71 that was discarded, who was actually a head of department, logistics and operations of INEC, should be brought back because he testified and he spoke to the documents from EC8A and EC8D and INEC registers, that he spoke to them. He was indeed cross-examined on them. But nothing was said about that today. So we cannot say that the Supreme Court does not know what he's doing because it is the last court. But one good thing about it is that there were two appeals. We had one. Governor Lalong also had his own cross appeal. Our appeal was dismissed. His own cross appeal was also dismissed. So I would say it was one over one. But we thank God for safe landing. But one thing I want to make clear is that the entire electoral jurisprudence of Nigeria needs to be changed. We need to do something very, very drastic. We must bring back Uwe's electoral reform, committee reports for us to look at it. Even the one headed again by the former Senate president, Senator Ken Nnamani, to see how we can rejig the electoral process and then bring in electronic voting and electronic counting and electronic transfer of records so that results are not manipulated from the polling unit to the ward level, to the local government level, to the state level, then to the federal level. As it is today, the provisions of the Electoral Act are heavily, heavily, heavily weighed and loaded against a petitioner. And that is why you see politicians, whenever elections are going on, they just tell their followers, just do anything you do. The important thing is that we must first win. When we win, let us meet at the court. Because they know that the obstacles that are legally and constitutionally mounted against a petitioner are overwhelming and gargantuan. So I think beyond these election petitions, the National Assembly needs to take a critical, hard look at our electoral laws with a view to reforming them. Because we can't go on like this. We are having a situation where governors, where senators, where House of Representatives members, where councillors, where chairmen of local governments, and even where presidents are being incubated and delivered by the courts to the electorates, contrary to the wishes of the Nigerian people. I think something should be done to allow votes to be counted and for the votes to count. For as long as we continue on this path, I can tell you Nigeria is not enjoying true democracy, which as defined in 1783 by Abraham Lincoln in his Gettysburg Declaration, is government of the people, for the people, and by the people. I do not see this Electoral Act or INEC, midwife in that.
We've reached the terminal and it is God that will be glorified. The governor has said it all. All we need to do now is to go back and reconcile with the opposition so that together we'll join hands to move Plateau forward. This is victory for democracy.
I think the judgment has brought out the legal principle laid down by the Supreme Court itself long before now, upon which any person challenging an election should follow to establish his allegation. In other words, what really happened was that the appellants brought witnesses who spoke Hausa. So by the law, if your evidence is translated into English from Hausa, you have to provide the two versions of the translated English and that of Hausa, so that the witness would adopt it. Now the court will now have the opportunity to look at the Hausa translation as well as English translation to confirm that they rhyme. In this case, they only brought the translated version of the witnesses. So the speaker said, no, you can't do that. You have to bring the two. If you brought only one, that's the end of it. You failed to establish your case. So that is it. And the second issue is that of certification. You know, the petitioners or the appellants sought to rely on some INEC documents, which are public documents. So there was not sufficient evidence of certification. Because if you are relying on public documents, you need to satisfy those documents. Otherwise, they are not acceptable or they are not receivable as evidence. So that's exactly what happened. Most of the documents the appellant produced before the election tribunal were satisfied, but the date of certification do not correlate with the receipt issued for the certification. Because if you certify a document, you must pay for the certification. You must issue with a receipt before your documents are receivable in evidence in court. So in the instance case, the appellant documents and the receipt, the date on the receipt, the date on the document do not correlate. So there was no way the court would now form an opinion that, okay, these receipts are for this document that you satisfy. So those are the crux of the matter here. So in other words, there was no evidence receivable right from the tribunal up to the Supreme Court to prove the overvoting alleged by the petitioner in Sokoto petition.
INEC and the governor of Kano, Alhaji Umar Ganduje. The summary of the decision of the Supreme Court is that the Supreme Court dismissed the appeal. He found that Abba Yusuf and his team brought the petition alleging that the election, that they won the election, scored the majority of lawful votes in the election, and that Ganduje did not score a majority of lawful votes. But the facts which they allege in the petition tended to show or pertain to the allegation of non-compliance
and corrupt practice.
So the Supreme Court held that when a person makes allegation that he won the election, it is not an umbrella which covers every infraction of the Electoral Act. And therefore, since the allegations which they made was not consistent with the sole ground which they based the petition on, if there was no basis upon which the court or the tribunal would have considered the allegation which they made, and therefore affirmed the decision of the tribunal and the Court of Appeal and dismissed the petition and affirmed Governor Ganduje as the duly elected governor of Kano State in the 2019 governorship elections that held. And I need to add that the Supreme Court is the final court in respect of election petitions or complaints against elections of governor. And therefore, today's decision marks the end of the process of challenging the election of the governor. We wish the governor well, trust that he will not have the peace of mind to concentrate and live.
The verdict today has really reaffirmed my faith in the judiciary of this country, and I want to affirm and restate that the people of Bauchi who have voted for me unanimously across party lines, I will make sure I will take them on that basis to consider them without any differences, to make sure that I give them good governance, to make sure that there is no any way anybody will be excluded or will be punished for anything. I'm extending a hand of fellowship and friendship to Mohammed Abubakar, the defeated governor or gubernatorial candidate of APC, to come and join hands with me to build Bauchi State so that we can take over from where he has left off, because we are all...
First of all, let me say that with this judgment, it has rekindled my confidence in the judiciary. I've always said the judiciary is the last hope of the common man, and the judiciary has exhibited that today. And I also want to say that I thank God, especially for the journey so far. We started from the trial court. We have reached the appeals court, and that is God's work. This one is final. And the next thing is the focus for the people of Plateau State. I extend my gratitude to to my lawyers, ably led by Latif Fagwemi, SAN, and all the other senior advocates who did a very wonderful job to take us to this level. The good people of Plateau who voted for me, today their mandate is revalidated. I thank them very much, and I will continue to serve them with all my strength and with all my my energy. And finally, the final appeal I will make to Nigerians, and especially myself, that have seen judgment today, is not to go and fight again. The election is finished, litigation is over, is now good governance to the people. All over, for me in Plateau State, I'm going to use this opportunity to embrace the openness on the other side, to bring them along, especially our father who took us up to this journey. I know that he is not tired, but we'll make sure we'll gain from his experience. We'll bring him together so that we can tap from his experience to move Plateau forward. Thank you very much.
Yes, we are very happy that we have won. You remember we won at the polls, we won at the election tribunal, we won at the Court of Appeal, and now we have also won at the Supreme Court. This is the end of the road. And now, His Excellency Governor Bala Mohammed can now concentrate to work and deliver the dividends of democracy to the good people of Bauchi State, who gave him freely and voluntarily this mandate, which the highest court of the land has confirmed and reaffirmed and validated today.
What reaction do you want me to make? We have reached the terminus. Supreme Court has delivered its judgment. It's based on two concurrent findings. And as you have heard from them, the appeal fails on all grounds. In other words, the eligibility, the credibility, and the well-conducted elections were all affirmed and reaffirmed by the Supreme Court. We are grateful to them.
Thank you very much.